I'm Baloo, and I've been traveling to discover destinations around the world and their relationships with nightlife and music. No place has risen in music tourism quite like Zanzibar, especially over the past 2 years when the rest of the world was locked down. All kinds of digital nomads have flocked to this East African island, historically known for its spice trade, to live a simpler lifestyle. I've been here twice in just the last year, and this island has now become the next nightlife destination, and I'm back to find out why.
Many people like me, they all came here and they find a place where they can keep doing what they love. But the president will say, we don't gonna close this country, because if you're gonna close this country, you're gonna die.
It's just mid-COVID. Our party event series has stopped in Bahrain. Standing in the middle of the dance floor in this majestic place, Zanzibar, we're like, why don't we do it here?
The problem we don't get any like real big support. My big dream like to go out of box, to go out of Zanzibar, like to present Zanzibar.
Do you want to represent Zanzibar?
Yeah, I try my best for
That's
sure.
That's cool. Zanzibar, we're approaching Paje. This is my third time here in 1 year. Paje has become kind of a global nightlife spot. A lot of big DJs come here, partly to relax, but also to play. And some people just never leave. They just stay here. They establish businesses. They just feel at home here. One of these really interesting businesses that kind of started this ripple effect, I would say, is Before, which is a restaurant, it's a beach club. It's where to go here to find some really decent electronic music. And it's always happening. Hi.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
How's it going?
Good.
Are you need a hangover?
I'm good. So I'm at one of Paje Beach's, I would say, musical institutions. Beyond being a place with the burgers and beats, I'm sitting with Alex and Tina from Before. Somewhere I've played before, actually, and really enjoyed. But I wanna know, since this is like the first drop in the big ripple effect that is what is now Paje Beach, what was before?
Before there was not much. Music-wise, there was not much going on. There was bongo flavor, reggaeton and bongo flavor. So the idea was play electronic music for the kite surfers, getting quick food, burger perfect. And then was like before, beach bar, burger, beats. We just opened the thing and from day one, it worked quite well.
A lot of our friends from all over the world said like, okay, we want to come, but we also want to stay with you guys. And this is actually how it happened when we started to think about, okay, good, let's build accommodation as well.
How did the pandemic affect Before?
Since Zanzibar didn't have that many restrictions and COVID didn't hit Zanzibar hard, we've been able to make events in a smaller group, right?
The main idea was to still find a platform for festival organizers, club owners, event planners, music lovers in general. Yeah. We created a concept. Yeah. You bring your people, you bring your DJs, we give you the playground. Mm-hmm. You do whatever you want.
How did you guys deal with like the expansion of this culture and on this beach?
So there is like an unspoken agreement between people who are having events, who was their first, this is their day.
I like it. You know, there's a lesson here, I think, for the rest of the world, you know, where you can actually create a balance and a community.
I think a lot of people forget that music should bring people together and not separate them.
Absolutely. I think it's a great establishment. I always enjoy coming here. I always recommend it to people when they fly here.
Most welcome. You know,
for me, Paje is very much Before.
Thank you.
just down the road from before, is a different kind of party. Afro House and Amapiano Beats bring a mix of locals, foreigners, and Maasai from the mainland in what has now become one of the largest weekly shindigs on this island. I wanted to meet with DJ Zorro, a Zanzibari DJ who hosts this party and provides the music, to find out exactly how the local scene is evolving. So we're on our way to Fuoni, which is it's like a town outside of Stone Town, just 10 minutes away. We're about to talk to a guy called Zahru, better known locally as DJ Zorro. He's, I think, two events that he works on. He's kind of a one-man show, does everything on his own. Yeah, we want to talk about the struggles of the local scene and how the locals see it evolving or getting better, just so we can get a taste of what's really happening on the ground.
Hey, hello. How are you?
Finally.
You're good?
Yeah, good.
How welcome,
are you?
Welcome,
thank
guy.
You. What do you think of the music scene here in Zanzibar? And, you know, over the years, what do you see changing as a local?
Local, we build a problem. Like, we don't get big support, you know.
Yeah.
And some of locals, they give up. When you're a DJ, you can't, like, get good money.
Yeah.
You know. We see, like, a lot of events happen, like, big events in Zanzibar.
Yeah.
When we ask them, like, how about local DJ support and give them a chance, or maybe do some interview, call local DJ, listen what they're doing,
right?
And maybe we can give them some chance to be better, you know? And I try many times to ask someone, say, we are full. I think like they don't trust, like, okay, we don't deal with local. Yeah, we have a lot of people who got talent, and we work together, we love each other.
So tell me, in terms of your party, what are your hopes? Like, you want it to become something you do on a weekly level, or?
My big dream, like, to go out of box, to go out of Zanzibar, like, to present Zanzibar.
So you want to represent Zanzibar?
Yeah, yeah, it's something like that. So I try my best, for
That's
sure.
cool. Soundscapes. This is its second run with only a few months on the island. It's a four-day festival organized by a group of my friends hailing from Bahrain. This festival has been making waves as one of the region's most well-curated events, built on human-centered principles and completely constructed by locals with locally sourced materials. So tell me about how long it took you to build all of this the first time around.
So it took us exactly 3 months. All of this didn't exist. We actually had the option of going with a company that was going to bring people from Germany. And we said that's going against the ethos of Soundscapes. We wanted people from the community, people from here to do it, to work with us, you know, to build something special here. This is new. So now, apart from the February one, we have a new entranceway to the DJ booth or the stage
right
from the back with plantation and a seating area there. Baloo, you'd actually make your way here on day two.
That's cool.
All right. Please do actually make your way here on day two. This is something new that we've done. It's called the Garden of Eden.
So we're taking advantage of all of the green, lush gardens and different areas to create some entertainment across the venue. So
full on, full experience.
Yeah.
We have less than how long?
We have
less than 24 hours.
Less than 24 hours. Everyone's excited.
Do you have enough time?
I want to say yes, but realistically, no. You know, we've been working tirelessly.
You could easily fool me. This looks pretty ready to me, so.
I think I'll be coming here again and again, and I think we all will be coming here again and again.
Yeah, same. Ross Moses is an Italian with African roots that has come to love Zanzibar and make it his home. We met and connected through music only a few months ago, and Ross Moses is now coming to tell us about his experience with this island.
How are you?
I can see you. How are you?
You left enough, right?
Now
it's time
to go crazy.
So tell me about your relationship with Zanzibar. How did it start?
I started working for Kendwa Rocks, who's making the biggest party in Zanzibar called Full Moon Party. It wasn't easy in the beginning because I was playing electronic music. I mean, the guy asked me some reggaeton music, African music, after 20 minutes. So I was forcing to have a security with me.
He put me like down, you know, when somebody doesn't understand, he put you down, I think.
But how did you see the evolution of the
The evolution
the music
is crazy scene, because step by step from 2016, 2018, there was a big change in Zanzibar. The East Coast start to make a different party because it's easiest in the East Coast to make party than the North.
Why?
Because the North, they are more 4 or 5 star hotel, so they don't allow the local a lot to go inside the hotel. They try to be more private.
Right.
Here is a more backpacker place. Even the beach is different. The North, you go to relax, to enjoy the beach. Here, many times you wake up, there is low tide. Tide is so far.
No,
so
what do we do? Let's dance. Let's dance.
How about local talent? Have you been encountering a lot?
I was supporting a lot of local talent to go show off in the Full Moon because it's a big scenario. And now I'm very happy to see, like, DJ Zorro now is doing his own party around. For me, it's good to be part of
evolution. Yes, that's nice. Evolution. That's nice. It's good for you too. It shows how dedicated you are to this.
Yeah, yeah. For me, you come here, you give me, you have to give back.
How did you see COVID affecting the evolution of the scene here? I mean, you were here before the big COVID wave.
I arrived in the airport. Even the police have no mask, nothing.
Yeah.
The president was saying, we don't gonna close this country, because if we're gonna close this country, we're gonna die.
Yeah.
So I arrived in a place where everything was open.
Yep.
Full Moon Party was still going with 4,000 people on the beach, dancing.
During that year, would you say Zanzibar was like probably the most happening place on the planet?
I think the only one.
The only place happening.
The pandemic was very good for Zanzibar because many people like me, they all came here. They find a place where they can keep doing what they love.
It has a ripple effect that's heard around the world, I think. The echoes are around the world. Everyone knows about what's happening in Zanzibar.
Knows.
What are you excited about today? I'm ready to go. And,
I'm super excited because I know
how I think
go.
It's good. Thank you.
I've been here for a week and it's been Hakuna Matata. I could move here, guys. I could move here.
We realized that we made such a successful product, and really the product was the culture. What a blessing it was really to find this place, because it's honestly, it's nothing short of magical.
Beyond its natural beauty and hospitable people, Zanzibar is a place for musical inspiration. Even though the festival is over, like other music destinations, the island will remain a staple for everyone that has attended, connected, and danced under its vibrant skies.